Holy time machine, Batman. This thing is an absolute, what a rush. Let me tell you, fellas, this thing is a lot of fun to ride. It revs out really nice and smooth, a little 125 two-stroke. The porting Yamaha had it down on this thing. It's got a straighter engineering Yamaha expansion chamber, so it gives it a little extra horsepower over stock. Just a kick-ass piece, man. What an absolute blast to ride. When I was the first time I took it out today, I was like, you know, this is why KTM and Penton went out of business or stopped dominating the market when Yamaha came out with their line of MX bikes, and the Japanese bikes were just so good. The engine, transmissions, the fit and finish, and the price. They're a lot less expensive than the other brands. Junior, what are your thoughts about this? I know you know quite a bit about this particular model.
Yeah, the pre-74 Yamaha MX bikes were built on the Enduro chassis, but had the high-strung porting in the head spec, and it was, of course, stripped down and in a little bit different trim, but somewhat obscure. You don't see a lot of these. And super rare, you see top end kits for the early AT and DT MXs going for big money. They call it the GYT kit, the genuine Yamaha tuning kit. And there's some cycle parts on this bike that can't be replaced. This is a very low time, clearly a low time original. The front fender is still present. Marcel, who's somewhat of a Yamaha expert, he restores these a handful a year. Had high praise for the bike and was commenting on the original front fender and how they were getting $800+ for those on eBay. This one does have a little bit of a crack that can be repaired, but it's present. Original paint, original stripe is still there, original paint in the tank. These are some items that just can't be replaced, but MX spec, it lives up to the hype. Definitely a little high-strung ripper in the bulletproof Enduro chassis. These are great.
Did I mention it's a hell of a lot of fun to ride too? It's an absolute hoot. The thing rips, little 125 two-stroke, and it's very similar. Well, my GT80 was this 1973, had I think the same paint job as this, very similar. Obviously scaled down model, but came with the stripes on the fender and everything. Total flashback time capsule machine. The chrome on the rims is real nice. The original forks are in good condition. A little pitting on the chrome on the uppers, but it's all original. It's a survivor that stood the test of time. I think the pictures explain the cosmetic condition. It's an excellent original paint condition.
Yeah, the kickstand's still present, and that's really indicative that the bike was never actually, it never made it to the track. It was never racing competition. This was owned by a collector that we bought 16 bikes from out of Stockton, California. He recently passed away this week. God rest his soul.
Sadly.
Killer guy with a top-notch collection enthusiast. And he got to a point financially he had to sell the bikes, and they came to us, and they all got refreshed and taking videos.
I'm sure he's smiling down in heaven today. He passed away last week. Sadly, I couldn't believe what Junior told me yesterday morning. I was like, wow, that really sucks. But I bet you he's smiling down from heaven knowing his bikes are in good hands now and as good as they've ever been. This one's just been gone through by the team here. The carb was clean, the tank was clean, air filter was done, new gear oil, did 100-point inspection, all the nuts and bolts, everything's been checked on it.
Marcel was ranting and raving on about the seat. This is a real MX seat, and it has a different profile than the Enduro seat. This one has the original cover. He says these are basically unobtainium. You cannot find them, and folks on eBay are asking big money for them. If you guys know, the Enduro market is ridiculous, finding an original front fender, especially for the earlier ones, the aluminum riveted front fenders, you know, they're basically worth their weight in gold, but it's the same thing with the MXs. These were much lower production, so, and of course, by nature, these were taken out and ridden in competition, so they saw a little bit harder use, but this one, I don't think we've ever had an AT3 MX,
nothing close to this. No, definitely not this particular model. But compression test at 125 PSI, which is excellent. Put a new spark plug in it. It's got new premix fuel, 94 octane non-ethanol with Bellray 2 teeth. They're mixed at 32:1. It's got a new fuel petcock, new fuel line, removed, disassembled, and cleaned the carb. Throttle cable was lubed, adjusted the clutch, replaced the transmission fluid, and put a new kill switch on it. So other than that, It's exactly the way it came in to us, which is excellent original condition. Even the shocks are in beautiful condition. Those are look like an aftermarket like upgrade to like a Coney or something like that. But they work good. They held me pretty good at 220 pounds. Bike was steam cleaned, polished, waxed, degreased. Touched up the frame, repainted the exhaust, cleaned up the engine a bit. It's an absolutely gorgeous, classic original. If you have any questions about it, give us a call. Like Junior said, these MX versions with the steel fenders and the original seat and tank paint are super hard to come by. It's an absolute classic that's a joy to ride and own and easy to maintain, easy to work on. It's lasted 50 years. I'm sure it's got another 50 years in it if you take care of it. So
looks like someone rebuilt the original shocks.
Are those the original shocks?
I'm not 100% sure. Marcel didn't comment on them, but
I think those are aftermarket upgrades to like a Coney or something like that, or an early works or something like that.
There's a cult following behind these bikes, so I know once we spring this one on eBay,
someone will tell us what they are.
Yeah, exactly. If there's anything,
I'd almost guess they're a Coney, but who knows?
If there's anything that we haven't mentioned, guys, go on eBay and shoot us a message. I'm very responsive.
Please do, yeah. We do know it's a Strader engineering pipe because it's got the chrome emblem on it still.
Stock carb.
Just a beauty.
Stock intake.
The pegs are nice and straight. The shifter and brake pedal have no indication of any damage. How's the bottom of the engine look?
Beautiful.
Hasn't been hammered off-road.
Like perfect, yeah, the bottom of the tank.
The 50-year-old chrome on the rims is in remarkably excellent condition. Yeah,
there's no rust poking through in the tank or anything like that. It's in really great shape.
It's a blaster ride. It's a little ripper. Good luck bidding on it. God bless America.